I would try to approach that. If it was a vote and there was, I guess, no legal expense or time, I would probably vote no. But, you know, we as taxpayers, we as county residents, you know, if we try to take legal action against this, it's going to end up costing the taxpayers resources, time, and money. And I think it's best that, you know, we wait and see what happens with the Commission on Local Government.
I would have voted to revision Henry County. You know, it's hard to get hypothetical. There's a lot that goes into the reversion conversation. And to just, you know, say yay or nay, and I don't have all of the information, so it would be hard to say yes or no. You know, this is a Martinsville-initiated agenda item, so it wouldn't have been initiated through Henry County. You know, Henry County would not be reverting to anything because we're already a county. So that's something that would have never, you know, come across the Henry County Board of Supervisors' desk.
But what I can say is the way it is now, my personal preference would have been to vote no. I think it's best for the county to vote no. And the thing that I heard from the county was, well, it's going to be expensive. If we vote no, we'll have legal fight, whatever. Well, my question is, how much more expensive is it going to be to continue to do this for the county when they take our tax base and start annexing all the way down to the Dutch Inn in Collinsville and all the way past the racetrack and Ridgeway? That's going to be expensive too.